Our next presentation is on Museo Camera, India's first museum for the photographic arts, which will be given by photographer, visual historian, and curator Museo Camera, Aditya Arya. Welcome, Aditya, and over to you.
So I brought my camera. It all started with this in 1970s when my dad gave me this camera. And this Zeiss icon is what really actually influenced the making of this museum. So this is where I come from, 40 years of advertising photography. I've been shooting resorts, products, industry, and ads. And as I mentioned, it all started with this camera, which is what my dad gave me in the 70s. So there was no internet, there was no WhatsApp, no Facebook. And we had to walk for a couple of kilometers to make a phone call. And the ultimate outings for me was when my dad used to take me to Lal Qila, the Kabadi Bazaar on Sundays, which was a fabulous place. And so this is what I ended up with. 2,500 cameras, wow, going back to 1850s. French invented photography, but on 19th August 1839, they gave it to the world, to the mankind as a gift. They removed the patent from photography. So it's kind of, my story of photography is ki there is a very deep link with the art and the craft, and you have to understand the craft. So, since I had collected all these cameras, few officials approached me in 2015 because my basement had become a talk of the town and a lot of visitors used to come there. They said, what would you like to do with it? I said, probably end up with a museum. So they offered me a place which was a disused badminton hall. It was 18,000 square feet and 0.75 acre of land, and the local villagers had started using it as a baratghar and daruk adda in the evenings. So this was the badminton hall, and this is where the museum is today. In 2017, we signed our MOU with the government of Haryana and MCG. It's probably the most unique MOU ever signed. It took me almost 1 year to convince the officers, as they wanted an IAS officer to be the head of this museum. I said, sorry, it will never work. And somehow a lot of officers believed in me, and they said, okay, we'll do a one-time investment of 4.5 crores. You will put in 2 crores, or whatever you think is you can, and you will have to run this. I said, provided you sign on a document, you will never interfere. So that was also agreed on a stamp paper. And we started working on the design. And so it was refurbishing, building, civil work, air conditioning to be done by them. It started as 4.5. Today it's around 8. And with the help of my friends, so everything was pro bono because we don't have that kind of money. We thought about a design, which was to make a. So the core principle was the presentation of the collection, interpretation center, and an experience for the visitor with a proper hospitality section. So, in the old days, the museums were known as ajayab ghars, where ajeebo gareeb cheezes were thrown at public. And so my whole idea was, it's not going to be an ajayab ghar, it's going to be an experience for people to walk in. And this is what... there are no places which teach you how to make museums. And I'm a self-taught photographer, so what I did was I picked up just about each and every book and started reading how to make museums. Some were very encouraging, some were very disappointing, because they said you need millions and millions. So I had visited lots of museums in the last 40 years while working as a travel photographer, and I actually had documented their lighting, the graphics. Now this came into a lot of help, and Jan 2018, we started the construction. The process was very tedious and frustrating. We discovered this building was standing on a lake bed, which was filled with plastic. And so the structural engineer said, this building cannot be constructed like this. So tender specs were all wrong. The MCG, the guys who prepared the tender, had forgotten major chunks of the building details, which we had actually submitted. So we have a very unique system, which is called L1. You know what an L1 is? The lowest tender. You have to deal with it. The government only gives L1. There is no parameters for quality in that. So you can see the plastic, and this loader work, I discovered the contractor who said, sir, ye to 10-12 saal mein ban jayega, don't worry. This is how government projects work. I said, this is not going to work with me. And I said, I'm going to take this forward. I said, get the machines. Let's start going deeper and deeper, and let's create a raft. Let's go down 10 meters down, and that's what we did. And I forced them to create a raft, and actually, they stopped working again. So I reached out to the government. I said, look, I'm walking out of this project. It's very frustrating. You got to penalize this guy. Somehow some officer actually saw some merit in it. He said, how much do you want to penalize? I said, as much as you can. He said, okay, let's penalize them for 45 lakhs. And it was published in each and every newspaper of India. So a penalty was imposed. This guy started working, and the structure started coming up. And the whole structure has been made using LGSF. What we've done is we've created a building inside a building without touching the existing building.
What is LGSF?
Light grade steel. It's quick. You will see I've created this museum in practically 10 months.
Wow.
So my job was to sit there. There were no architects. There are government doesn't have consultants. Government doesn't have a contract. It's just an L1 contract is thrown, and that guy is supposed to do everything. It was bizarre. So I was calling up friends and saying, I'm moving this diwar. It girega to nahi. Thoda sa jara load factor calculate karke batao. And this is how it worked. I used to send them clippings every day. People used to call me to send me measurements. This is what the building looked like in 6 months' time. So I was the key person, architecture, electrical, and everything else. Why I'm showing you this is very interesting. I was there documenting the process. I created books for the government. Every day I shot 400-500 images to keep everything under control. So his mixtures, his whatever steel he was getting. I used to go down to the factory from where he was getting the steel. I was a nightmare. He said he'll never work with me ever again. He said, jitna paisa banana tha, wo bhi dubo diya mera. So one of the biggest problem for me was the scope, my work, which was display cases. I started reaching out to companies, you know, who makes these display cases, Chinese companies, Indian companies, these display cases cost lakhs and things. And I started researching, okay, how much space will I require for each camera company, the story of the cameras, and actually had to create a system which everybody is aware of, Jugad. So got hold of local carpenters and created a system, started doing mock-ups. So since we didn't have the money, I involved friends, and I used to print everything in-house. There are just four of us doing everything there. So a lot of friends from graphics, my advertising colleagues joined in. That's Gopika Chawla and her team. Carpenters started constructing the Jugad, the display cases. This is what this Jugad looks like. We created a Jugad using a shoebox system. So all the cases actually open like shoebox. The lid is what is actually fixed on the wall. Our display systems. Lighting was another big challenge. I contacted a lot of companies, and Zal from Austria decided to help us because they said this is a unique. They've never come across a museum. This is what the museum looks like today. It's we created installations, huge installations using cameras. One of the biggest problems which I have faced is there are no big institutes of museology, or you have National Museum. They are churning out students who have absolutely no idea about how to run a museum. They're not taught even the basics, but they all have degrees. And I mean, one 24-year-old intern told me that he's not here to clean the objects and displays. He's here to do bigger things. Can you please not ask me to clean these things? That's museology students. This is what our art galleries look like. So the story of photography is the story of evolution from silver grains to megapixels. So we've created a lot of installations using cameras, and this is what the museum space looks like. We've created 19th century studios inside the museum. So there's a myth that museums are created and established by millionaires. I'm not a millionaire, but just an ordinary photographer. My father was a professor who only gave me this camera to start with. So I took the route of crowdfunding this. I mean, we are short of funds, but we have finished good 80% of the museum. It's been launched day before yesterday. So we have a proper functional dark rooms, lecture halls, workshop areas. As you enter the museum, I've created two huge walls which are dedicated to the people who worked with me, the workers. So we've created a huge space actually honoring them. I mean, these are the people who never get recognized for doing what they really do. And since I was there with them for the last 1 year, this is what the museum looks like from outside today. So it's been thanks to many friends who have helped me. I have 2 full-time staff and 2 interns. That's how this museum was made, and that's how this museum is run. It's 18,000 square feet, and it's spread over 0.75 acre of land. And we don't know where we are heading, but we are at it. So this is how we started. So this is the most important wall for me, the people who are recognized, people, individuals who actually paid for the museum, my friends. We've created a huge wall, and everyone's name is there. And as I walk out today, I'm going to be handing over a small request to all of you. Find people to create museums, please. Well, I would like to thank Sanjoy, Asa, Dwani, and everyone here, because I wasn't going to come here till he said I'm going to pay for the ticket. We are short of funds. We don't have funds. Thank you very much. Thank you. Thank you all.